dear students, today's lesson is on worker-client relationship in casework practice. Social work has methods, and all the methods, including casework, group work, community organization, the relationship is the basis for the transactions of the worker and the client. Worker-client relationship will help in identifying the psychosocial needs of the individual, and it also helps in the self-disclosure of the client about his problem to the worker. The worker-client relationship will enhance the effectiveness of psychosocial treatment. The lesson explains about the worker-client relationship. Objectives of the lesson. On completion of the lesson, you will be able to understand the nature of worker-client relationship, identify worker-client relationship, its uses in interviewing, assessment, and treatment. 3. Explain the concept of authority. The methods of social work, casework, group work, community organization are grounded in the art and science of relationship. Professional relationship is not just friendship. Client brings into the casework relationship feelings and attitudes and behavior which they have experienced with others. The worker tries to know the psychosocial needs of the client. The extent the client will make use of the casework relationship depends upon the kind and quality of emotional needs and the type of personality. Casework situations require strong worker-client relationship. The caseworker creates a comfortable atmosphere by accepting the client and recognizing his needs, respecting the rights to manage his own affairs. The client will experience a kind of relationship for satisfying his needs and attain goal of treatment and the function of the agency itself. Transference or transference reactions may also manifest themselves not in their words of the client in his behavior. The client may be obedient, helpless, approval seeking, resistant, or defying. These reactions can be recognized with the stimuli coming from the caseworker. When the clients are helpless, they transfer irrational elements into the relationship. Such circumstances of helplessness state, generally, the client will regress, requiring both the parental nurture and parental domination. The relationship will be maintained on the basis of reality. Both the worker and the client have their separate realistic identities. If transference reactions are seen, the worker has to recognize and identify and help protect the relationship. And by strengthening ego, the worker will help the client resolve such transference reactions. The client will experience a kind of relationship for satisfying his needs and attain the goal of treatment and the function of the agency itself. Relationship is the basic positive feeling and sometimes negative or ambivalent feelings towards the process. The relationship ranges from an objective relationship in which the worker seen as much as distrusted. The client, because of the distortion developed during childhood, may not be able to understand the worker. The client will bring feelings and attitudes of his childhood to his present relationship. The phenomena is known as transference. Development of relationship is affected by agency settings, such as medical setting, correctional settings, and educational settings. Nature of the problem, whether it is simple or complicated, situational or personality problem, etc., also will influence the relationship. Two other influencing factors of relationship are being the goal sought and the personality makeup of the worker, marked by maturity, helplessness, sensitivity, courage and creativity. The worker has to understand the complicated transference, or else he finds the case in an unmanageable situation. Such manifestations are temporary. When an actually ill person worships the nurse during treatment, after recovery, he becomes normal and perceives her as professional serving them. Perceiving people objectively indicate maturity of the individual. Definition of relationship. According to Norton, relationship is primarily emotional responses which ebb and flow from person to person as human behavior evokes different affective reactions. According to Perlman, it is a condition in which persons with same common interest between them, long-term or temporary, interact with feelings. Bierstadt defines relationship. The purpose of professional relationship has been called in interplay, a mutual emotional exchange, an attitude, a dynamic interaction, a medium, a connection between two persons, and a professional meeting and the neutral process. Coyle considers relationship as discernible process by which people are connected with each other and around which the group takes its shape and form. Uses of relationship in interviewing. The more disturbed person, the more is essential that relationship should be strong enough to permit him to disclose his or her problems, to give information regarding the facts and events of his life, history. The client's ability to reveal will depend on his trust for the worker. These facts and events are important for diagnosis and treatment of the case. The client has to understand the reason for giving his personal history. The worker should not disturb the tempo of revelation while revealing the client's feelings of guilt and defenses are used. People tend to think that their own emotional conflicts are private and do not require any help, anybody's help, and seek treatment for real problems such as loss of job or problem of a child. The caseworker works at a slow pace and does not mean she is passive. The worker's slowness indicates her control over curiosity and impulse, and it also gives to the client to have self-knowledge which helps in further transactions. Sometimes the client starts asking personal questions. This is appreciable as the client is showing interest in the worker and it indicates positive relationship. The worker, when she is asked about her personal life, tactfully has to change the conversation. But some inexperienced workers start answering the questions and finally end in chatting, deviating from the purpose. Ethical considerations. Every caseworker has a set of ethical obligations in her practice. This includes obligations to the client, to the community, and to himself. Caseworker's responsibility includes respect and acceptance of the client as a person and as a human being. Here, the client is not a problem, but person with a problem. The client may never be exploited nor may his social situation be exploited for personal gain. The worker has to carry out the plans for and with the client on the basis of professional judgment. The caseworker has to give his guidance, which is not casual, impulsive, or hurried. She has to focus on her guidance in releasing capacity of the client for responsible decisions and actions. Appointment mates with the client should be punctual, and privacy for interviews has to be maintained. Promises always sparingly made should be fulfilled in case of unavoidable circumstances and unforeseen circumstances. Reasons should be explained to the client, and it is always wiser to make few promises and never give false hopes for one's ability to solve the problem. The confidential relationship. One of the most important ethical considerations is the nature of relationship within which confidence of the client is protected. The client, in the interest of solving his problem, reveals even the most intimate personal incidences and matters to the worker. The worker should not discuss with anyone and also should not use it for gossip. The worker, with experience, learns excellent interview skills, and the client also tends to yield himself fully, trusting the worker, solving the problem. This is possible if only the caseworker and the agency protected the privacy of the client. Self-knowledge in the relationship. That is, general observation is certain kinds of personality seems to be helpful to people, and other types of personality is harmful to human beings. Caseworkers, when they start working with families, will come to know that how often their personal family interaction will influence objectivity. The worker should understand her own feelings and attitudes. For her feelings and attitudes, the cause is unconscious motivation. Insight and awareness are prerequisite in an ethical use of relationship. The caseworker has to understand her own feelings and be able to accept others. Ability to know one's own feelings is important to understand feelings of others. Caseworker's understanding of her feelings as well as that of the client will give security to the client. Caseworker is of no use if she has no real interest and concern for the client. The caseworker will never be useful if she is not having real interest and is engrossed with unnecessary curiosity or desire to manage or a need to have client's love for her and what she is doing. The caseworker should resist her impulse to threaten or punish or withhold favors. In any profession, aiming to help people, knowledge of self and its use in relationship is essential. The caseworker should have knowledge of self to recognize her own subjectivity, prejudices, and biases. The caseworker will be in a confused state when she is unable to differentiate her feelings and that of the client. The worker tries to overcome her defenses and achieve greater objectivity and control. Client involvement in change. Client makes his or her own decisions to use his or her abilities, resources to work out his or her problems, whereby achieving the goal of self-help. The client's problem may be an economic or a psychological in origin with the guidance of the worker. He or she develop new insight and new skills with renewed efforts to change his or her circumstances and his or her attitudes. Here the worker with her professional skills motivates the clients to use his or her personal and social resources in working with his or her difficulties and achieve his or her own solution. The use of authority. Worker uses authority occasionally in the interest of the client by way of giving suggestions. Authority in any setting indicates worker's status and his expert training, and it is not used forcibly or in the form of threat in certain settings like courts, child protection services, and in similar agencies. Authority is very common. Authority cannot be used clinically without full knowledge of the development of the personality. The deficiencies in the development personality includes rebellion, aggression, or neurotic character deviation, which are the outcome of inadequate parenting. Caseworker, when she is working with neurotic parents, she has to learn about authority as much as she learns about principles of rights and needs. So far, the clinical use of release of feelings is understood. The clinical use of a restraint of impulse, for example, in working with primary behavior disorders, psychopaths, character disorders, and certain phases of psychosis, and all those who act out their impulses. The caseworker has to help the client developing internal and external restraints. In case the client fails to do so, the caseworker has to exercise her authority. Children need to be controlled as they need to be loved, and the restraints are internalized because of the loving and nurturing relationship. Some yield authority, whereas others are not guided by authority. On such occasions, they turn to court even for the minor conduct problems. They need an authoritarian political party, religion, or a judge. Generally, the course lies in unresolved parental experiences and from the other social and cultural conditioning. In case of milder disturbances in the family, the objective treatment brings the client back to reality. Generally, the person who has stronger ego and reasonable superego has better sense of reality, but delinquent children have distorted ideas of reality and of punitive relationship. They will think everybody is ready to hurt them, and an experienced worker with the skills begin to change the attitude of such children. The sharing of professional guidance from more than one worker needs multiple worker relationship. A social case may have several related or separated problems. For example, an economic problem may involve a health problem in the same family. Sometimes, more than one client may be involved. That is, husband and wife, or parent and child, or patient and relative are at a time helped by a caseworker. Though it is difficult to assign clear-cut functional roles in the cases mentioned, different workers work in a team help the clients. Another aspect of multiple worker approach arises from the way intake is managed in the agencies. Depending on the workload, the intake is done in most instances. Summary. The methods of social work, casework, group work and community organization are grounded in the art and science of relationship. The caseworker creates a comfortable atmosphere, accepting the client, recognizing the needs and respecting the right to manage his own affairs. The client experiences a kind of relationship to satisfy the needs and to reach the goal of treatment. A relationship involves both positive as well as negative feelings. During interview, the relationship will permit free disclosure of the client of the history of his problem to the worker. The ethics the professional caseworker is having will strengthen the relationship. The attitudes and feelings of the client towards the worker is known as transference. The worker's own feelings and attitude towards the client has to be controlled. To deal with the cases is known as counter-transference. Questions. What is professional relationship? Discuss the importance of worker-client relationship. Explain the use of multiple worker relationship. In what way worker-client relationship help in interviewing the client? Discuss the contribution of transference to worker-client relationship. References. Hamilton Gordon, 1948, Theory and Practice of Social Casework, New York and London, Columbia University Press. Perlman Helen Harris, 1957, Social Casework, A Problem Solving Process, Rawat Publications, New Delhi. Northrup Helen, 1959, Social Work with Groups, New York, Columbia University Press. Bastick Felix, The Casework Relationship, Chicago, Loyola University Press. Coyle Grace L, Group Work with American Youth, New York, Harper and Row, 1963.